The pathogenic species belong the genus of Neisseria, and to define the most disease caused it. The second objective, to demonstrate the laboratory diagnosis of these bacteria. 3, to manage prevention, control, and recommended treatment. As we know, bacteria can be classified according to the accessibility or to getting gram stain into gram negative and gram positive. In addition to that, bacteria can also divided according to the morphological arrangement into bacilli, cocci, and coccobacilli. According to that, Neisseria are gram-negative coccobacilli. This genus contain 2 pathogenic species and many commensals. These commensals, harmless, that inhabit upper respiratory tract and alimentary tract. The 2 pathogenic species included Neisseria meningitidis, which is also known as meningococcus, and Neisseria gonorrhea, which also known as gonococcus, Neisseria meningitidis, which causes a disease called meningitis, inflammation of meninges that cover the brain, while Neisseria gonorrhea causes gonorrhea. بالعربي يسمو السيلان. One of the most important sexually transmitted disease. One of the most important sexually transmitted disease. The two pathogenic species exclusively a human disease. The two pathogenic species exclusively a human disease. Firstly, I'm going to talk about the general characteristic of genus Neisseria. Neisseria are gram-negative diplococci, pears in shape, and it is half a characteristic shape called kidney bean shape. This bacteria fastidious and require enrichment media, so it is can well cultivated on chocolate agar. Neisseria meningitidis and Neisseria gonorrhea closely related to each other. Neisseria meningitidis and Neisseria gonorrhea closely related to each other, with 70% DNA homology. There are many laboratory tests used to differentiate between Neisseria meningitidis and Neisseria gonorrhea. Neisseria meningitidis and Neisseria gonorrhea have ability to ferment carbohydrate mainly glucose, maltose, lactose, and saccharose. Glucose, maltose, lactose, and saccharose. And this carbohydrate used to differentiate between all species of Neisseria, between all species of Neisseria. From that, Neisseria meningitidis maltose fermenta, while Neisseria gonorrhea, glucose fermenta. While Neisseria gonorrhea, glucose fermenter. While Neisseria gonorrhea, glucose fermenter. In addition to that, we can differentiate between Neisseria meningitis and Neisseria gonorrhea according to the clinical manifestations. Neisseria meningitis. It is meningitis. And the sample in this case, either CSF sample or blood. While Neisseria gonorrhea causes gonorrhea. And the sample in this case, either in male urethral discharge, or in female high vaginal swab, all Neisseria species, all Neisseria species, oxidase positive, all Neisseria species, oxidase positive. That means it possesses the enzyme called cytochrome C, cytochrome C. In addition to that, Neisseria gonorrhea, Neisseria species, possess a variant in cell wall structure. This variant called lipo-oligosaccharide, LOS, LOS. So in briefly, Neisseria species contain two pathogenic species, Neisseria meningitidis and Neisseria gonorrhea. All Neisseria gram negative diplococci. Neisseria meningitidis and Neisseria gonorrhea exclusively human pathogens, and can differentiate between Neisseria meningitidis and Neisseria gonorrhea depending on biochemical tests such as ability to ferment carbohydrate and also according to the clinical manifestations. Firstly, Neisseria meningitidis. As all Neisseria species, Neisseria meningitidis, gram negative diplococci, that means they have the same character of all species of Neisseria. From that, it is oxidase positive, gram negative diplococci, and produce smooth and small colony of blood. The most important character of Neisseria meningitidis, it is contain capsule. So this bacteria encapsulated according to the capsular polysaccharide, meningococcus has at least 13 sero group. According to the capsular polysaccharide, meningococcus has at least 13 zero group. But the most important disease producing zero group are A, P, C, X, Y, and W-135. Then in Neisseria meningitis, according to the capsular polysaccharide, classified into 13 zero group, but only 6 zero group disease producing to human, but only 6 zero group have ability to cause this disease to human, in which A, B, C, X, Y, and W-135. Neisseria meningitis rank second to Streptococcus pneumonia as a causes of meningitis, but the most common cause in individual between the age of 2 to 19 years. هذا يعني إنه Neisseria meningitis تسبب المنينجايتس بالأعمار من 2 إلى 18 سنة. There are many virulence factors that enhance pathogenicity of Neisseria meningitis. As all gram-negative bacteria, Neisseria meningitis have endotoxin, LBS, which causes fever, shock, and other pathophysiological changes. And as we mentioned above, Neisseria meningitis encapsulated bacteria, so it is surrounded by polysaccharide capsule. And in addition to that, it is half and produce IgA protease, which is cleave the secretory IgA, cleaving the secretory IgA, degradation in immunoglobulin IgA. So this is the virulence factor that enhance pathogenicity of Neisseria meningitis. Pathogenesis and pathogenicity of Neisseria meningitis, quiescent member of nasopharyngeal flora. So it is a microbiota, normal flora, found in nasopharyngeal area. But under certain conditions, these bacteria can invade non-ciliated macrovilli, non-ciliated epithelial cell, non-ciliated macrovilli that lining the nasopharyngeal area, and use this macrovilli to prelude to invasion. So this bacteria have ability to invade non-ciliated macrovilli and use these macrovilli for prelude to invasion. Once the meningococci can access to bloodstream, the pathogenicity enhanced by all the virulence factor we mentioned above, such as capsular polysaccharide, LBS, and endotoxin. The two most important clinical manifestation and disease caused by Neisseria meningitis is meningococcus meningococcemia, meningococcemia, the two most important clinical manifestation caused by Neisseria meningitidis is meningococcemia and meningitis. And the most important and fulminant meningococcemia caused by Neisseria meningitis, which which is called Fredriksen, which is called Waterhouse-Fredriksen syndrome. Waterhouse-Fredriksen syndrome. Waterhouse-Fredriksen syndrome, one of the most and fulminant meningococcemia. It is life-threatening disease, and it is medically emerging condition. Medically emerging conditions. This condition characterized by this condition, I mean Waterhouse-Fredriksen syndrome, characterized by circulatory collapse and respiratory failure. Waterhouse-Fredriksen syndrome, it is a condition in which adrenal gland failure due to bleeding into this gland lead to high fever, hemorrhagic rash, disseminated intravascular coagulation, thrombocytopenia, and adrenal insufficiency. Then adrenal insufficiency and lead to death. While in case of this figure show hemorrhagic rash resulting from Neisseria meningitis, while this figure show death, Waterhouse-Fredriksen syndrome, this figure show a case of death from Waterhouse-Fredriksen syndrome. The classical feature in case of meningitis, as you know, the classical feature including neck stiffnesses, photophobia, phenophobia, and sometimes cranial nerve pulses, and maybe lead to focal neurological disorder, such as aphasia and ataxia. Now, what the laboratory diagnosis of Neisseria meningitis? The most important laboratory diagnosis is you must know the type of specimen. In case of Neisseria meningitis, the specimen used blood for culture and smear, and also CSF. Blood culture smear can detect gram negative diplococci, kidney shape. The culture of Neisseria meningitis required 5% CO2. So, the first most important pathogenic bacteria belong to the Neisseria species is Neisseria meningitis, which causes two important clinical manifestations, meningitis and meningococcemia. And one of the most important fulminant meningococcemia is a disease called Waterhouse-Fredriksen syndrome, in which this syndrome results from adrenal insufficiency due to massive bleeding into adrenal gland. The diagnosis of this bacteria depends on type of specimen, which is either blood or CSF, and also we can use gram stain as a primary diagnosis for this bacteria, and also we can use culture technique to cultivate these pathogens. The second bacteria, the second group of bacteria, Neisseria gonorrhoeae. Sugar fermentation. This figure show the gram stain for Neisseria species. You can see gram negative diplococcal. This is an oxidase test. راح ناخذ هذا بالعملي وتشوفون التفاصيل مالته كاملة في مختبر العملي. هذا oxidase test. حالة البوزيتيف والنيجاتيف، حالة البوزيتيف والنيجاتيف، وراح إن شاء الله تشتغلوه وتشوفوه في الجانب العملي. Prevention of Neisseria meningitis. Prevention of Neisseria meningitis to date found quadrivalent capsular polysaccharide vaccine. Capsular polysaccharide vaccine, highly effective in adults, but not in infants and children less than 2 years of age. Two serogroup found in this vaccine. Serogroup B meningococcal vaccine now introduced and found as a vaccine to prevent serogroup B, because the first vaccine, quadrivalent capsular vaccine, can give protections only against ACY and 135, while other vaccine used to prevent meningococcal infections against group B, serogroup B of Neisseria meningitis. Can we often eradicate the carrier state and by using prophylaxis antibiotics such as rifampin, ciprofloxacin as a prophylaxis, mainly for household and other close contact individual. So when you can use rifampin and ciprofloxacin as prophylaxis for eradicate the carrier state. In case of Neisseria meningitis. So the prevention of Neisseria meningitis depends on vaccine, which is two types of vaccine: quadrivalent capsular polysaccharide vaccine, which can give protections against ACY W135O groups Neisseria meningitidis, while the second type of vaccine can give overall protections against two serogroups B, meningococcal vaccine against serogroup B. The second pathogenic bacteria we are discuss in this lecture are Neisseria meningitis, Neisseria gonorrhea, Neisseria gonorrhea. Neisseria gonorrhea have the same character of all species of Neisseria, the same character of all species of Neisseria. The general characteristic of Neisseria gonorrhea, gram-negative diplococci, gram-negative diplococci, kidney shape, have ability to ferment glucose only. And this bacteria, I mean Neisseria gonorrhea, non-capsulated. But the bacteria have all virulence factor that also found in Neisseria meningitis. That mean it's have LBS, IgA proteases, and LOS, lipoligosaccharide. لمعلوماتكم الطبية, LOS هو عبارة عن LBS, لكن ما بي الO antigen, ما بي الO antigen. مثل ما تعرفون أو انطوكم في المحاضرات, الاندوتوكسين اللي موجود بالجرام نيجاتيف بكتيريا, الاندوتوكسين الموجود بالجرام نيجاتيف بكتيريا, هذا الاندوتوكسين يتكون من يتكون 3 باتس, ليبيد اي والاو انتيجين والكور. نقول ال او اس, سم بكتيريا لاك تو او انتيجين. عندما تفقد البكتيريا الاو انتيجين, ال بي اس يسمى ال او اس, وهو ايضا فيريولنس فاكتور, بيكوز ات از ميميك تو سفينوليبيد فاوند ان برين اند اذر تيشو, ولهذا هو يعتبر فيريولنس فاكتور, ولهذا هو يعتبر فيريولنس فاكتور. اوكي, في النايسيريا منينجيتيس والنايسيريا جونوري also possess LOS, lipo oligosaccharide. But other important factor found in Neisseria gonorrhea, it is antigenic structure of this bacteria, antigenic structure of gonococci. Neisseria gonorrhea antigenically heterogeneous, that's mean it's have ability to change its surface structure, to avoid host defense. And this mechanism can be facilitated by various virulence factor and structure such as villi, poor protein, OPA protein, and other virulence factor that above mentioned, such as LOS, IgA proteases, and reduction modifiable protein, which is other virulence factor found in Neisseria gonorrhoeae. So in addition to other virulence factor found in Neisseria meningitis, such as IgA proteases, lipoligosaccharide, LOS, Neisseria gonorrhoeae possess other virulence factor that enhance their pathogenicity and facilitated invasion of target tissue. This other virulence factor including Fanberia of pili, poor protein, OPA, which is opacity protein, and reduction modifiable protein. All these virulence factor used from bacteria to escape from immune system, to overwhelm the immune system. As we mentioned above, Neisseria gonorrhoeae causes gonorrhea in both male and female, which is one of the most important sexually transmitted disease. So Neisseria gonorrhoeae or gonococci can cause both localized infection and disseminated infection. In both male and female. Localized infection, usually in genital tract, which is gonorrhea, one of the most important sexually transmitted disease. In male, gonorrhea characterized by urethritis with dysuria and purulent discharge. And sometimes this infection can disseminate to involve and lead to epididymitis and prostatitis. While in women, the localized infections causes cervicitis in women or in female, gonorrhea characterized by cervicitis, salpingitis, which is infection of uterine tube, PID, pelvic inflammatory disease, and sometime leading to sterility or ectopic pregnancy as a result to fibrosis of uterine tube. So the clinical finding of Neisseria gonorrhoeae, either localized infection in male characterized by urethritis with purulent discharge and sometime lead to epididymitis and prostatitis, while in female, gonorrhea characterized by cervicitis, salpingitis, which is infection of uterine tube, pelvic inflammatory disease, and sometime this infection in female lead to sterility or ectopic pregnancy. Sterility and ectopic pregnancy as a result to fibrosis of uterine and scarring of uterine tube. While disseminated infection, including septic arthritis, and skin manifestation, septic arthritis and skin manifestation, one of the most important disseminated gonococcal infection. Including septic arthritis. Septic arthritis mainly in sexually active adult, and sometimes lead to skin manifestation, ulcer and vascular skin manifestation. In addition to that, gonorrhea can cause proctitis, and lead to bloody and purulent discharge from the anorectal area, mainly, and this infection mainly occur in homosexual individual. And if the female during a pregnancy infected with Neisseria gonorrhea during delivery, this bacteria can transmit it to the eye of the infant and lead to purulent conjunctivitis in a newborn infant, lead to purulent conjunctivitis called ophthalmia in unatrum. So ophthalmia in unatrum, it is a purulent conjunctivitis result from gonococcal infection acquired from the mother during delivery, And pharyngitis, and other complication may also occur as a result to infection with Neisseria gonorrhea. Laboratory diagnosis. This figure show ophthalmia in unatrum, of newborn infant, Laboratory diagnosis in male differ from in female. Gonococci, gonorrhea in male, differ from laboratory diagnosis in female. And this lab test we are discuss during practical laboratory, we are discuss that, but you put, you must put in your mind the in male gram stain, definite diagnosis, for gonorrhea, while in female gram stain, it is just a presumptive diagnosis for diagnosis of gonorrhea, because vaginal mucosa of female contain many gram negative resembling to Neisseria gonorrhea. يعني الجرام ستين بالميل يجيك ميل عند urethral discharge, ودزيته للمختبر for gram stain, الجرام ستين بالميل definite diagnosis. يعني إذا أجاك Neisseria gonorrhea positive, so that's mean Neisseria gonorrhea. ولكن بالفيميل الجرام ستين just a presumptive diagnosis, ما ممكن تعتمد على الجرام ستين في تشخيص الجونوريا بالفيميل, لأنه الفاجينال ميوكوزا, contain a huge number of bacteria resembling in shape to Neisseria gonorrhea, So in female, you know, the definite diagnosis of Neisseria gonorrhea depend on culture. Depend on culture. لازم تدز كلتشر حتى تقول انه هذا المريض عنده نايسيريا جونوريا، هذا المريض عنده نايسيريا جونوريا. Prevention, the prevention of gonorrhea involves the use of safety measure and treatment of symptomatic patient and their contact. There is no vaccine in case of Neisseria gonorrhea. There is no vaccine in case of Neisseria gonorrhea. Treatment of Neisseria gonorrhea. Penicillin is the in the past is a drug of choice in case of gonorrhea, but this bacteria producing penicillinase that degradation penicillin drug. And this bacteria become multi-drug resistance to drug resistance to penicillin so another drug or second line used in this case, which is tetracycline, but also this bacteria converted to resistance to tetracycline. Today, they use the fluoroquinolone, azithromycin, sevotrioxone, and other drug to treatment of Neisseria gonorrhea, one of the most problem used in Neisseria, one of the most problem in a treatment of Neisseria gonorrhea is ability of this bacteria to became resistance to a wide range and variety of drug due to the presence of plasmid and chromosomal structure, and this bacteria became a multi-drug resistance to many recommended treatment today. As we mentioned, the genus Neisseria contain many commensal species that inhabit upper respiratory tract and alimentary tract. These bacteria harmless. Or microbiotic. But under certain condition, it may causes respiratory tract and lower respiratory tract. One of the most important commensal Neisseria species that inhabit upper respiratory tract is Moraxylla catarrhalis. This genus can causes lower respiratory tract and pneumonia. Tracheobronchitis and pneumonia and Moraxylla catarrhalis can be differentiated from Neisseria by it is inability to ferment any carbohydrate. So Neisseria Moraxylla catarrhalis did not ferment any carbohydrate, any sugar, saccharose, lactose, maltose. Moraxylla catarrhalis did not ferment any sugar. The last point in this The last part in this lecture is Acinetobacter baumannii or Acinetobacter baumannii, which is a common cause. It is also gram-negative bacteria resembling to Neisseria on smear, but it is oxidase negative. Acinetobacter baumannii oxidase negative. Oxidase negative. It is one of the a public health challenge due to ability to MDR acquisition. MDR acquisition. This bacteria, a common cause of serious wound infection among soldiers served in Iraq during Iraq war. هاي البكتيريا هي يسمونها Iraqi bacter, because it is a common causes of serious wound infection among soldiers served in Iraq during Iraq war, or who sustained traumatic injury and environmental condition during injury, as well as acquisition during medical care, had been proposed as a potential source for infection with Acinetobacter baumannii. This bacteria frequently isolated from hospital acquired pneumonia, ventilator associated pneumonia, and one of the most important character of this bacteria, it is ability to became MDR and acquisition of resistance to many and all treatment and antibiotic used for eradicate bacterial infection. But this bacteria oxidase negative. Oxidase, it is resembling to Neisseria species, but it is oxidase negative.